and welcome back to What's New with Microsoft 365. I am here today with Vivian.
And this is the amazing Candace. So why don't we just get started with updates for this month?
Cool. So we're going to start with the GA update in Excel. This is called Sheet View. Sheet View lets you sort and filter data and then select an option to make those changes just for yourself or viewable to everyone else in the spreadsheet. If you choose the option to make the change just for yourself, you can also save the results to view again as a separate view. This is really great if you want to collaborate in real time with others, but don't want to disrupt their workflow in a shared workbook. All you need to do here is click the View tab in Excel and find the sheet view you want from the drop-down list on the left side of the ribbon. Support for Excel for the web will come by the end of the year. You might remember that I talked a little bit about dark mode for OneNote for Mac previously, but now it's available for OneNote 2016. So we're gonna throw it over to Arthur to give us a little more information on the subject there.
With me right now is software engineer Bella Smith, and she's going to talk to us about dark mode for OneNote 2016. Bella, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
So let's talk about dark mode for OneNote 2016. Why were customers wanting this feature?
So we saw that dark mode has been one of our most loved features on our other endpoints, such as OneNote for Windows 10, OneNote for iPhone, and OneNote for Mac. So whenever we decided to maintain mainstream support for OneNote 2016, bringing dark mode to this platform was just an obvious choice.
And how do you turn on dark mode in the app?
So to turn on this feature, you'll go to the options panel in OneNote 2016 and toggle your office theme to black. This is the same way that you toggle on dark mode for our other office apps, such as Word and Excel. So if you have dark mode turned on for one of your office apps, it'll automatically turn it on for OneNote 2016 as well.
And who is this available for?
So this is available to all Office 365 subscribers.
Well, thank you very much, Bella, for your time.
Thank you.
The November update for Windows 10 is now here.
Woo.
This update, also known as Windows 10 version 1909, offers new things like Windows Search Experience and Explorer, and a ton of other updates you should check out. If you're ready to install the update on your personal device, search for and open your Windows Update settings and select Check for Updates. Once the update appears, or if you've already checked for updates, select Download and Install Now. If you're an IT admin, you can initiate targeted deployments through Windows Server Update Services and Windows Update for Business. We have a bunch of new Microsoft security updates, and Arthur's going to tell us a lot more about that.
With me right now is Adam Barron, and Adam is the Director of Product Marketing, and he's going to talk to us about Microsoft security. Adam, how are you?
I'm great, Arthur. Thanks for having me.
Great. So talk to us about Microsoft security. What's new this month?
Yeah. You know, as you know, security is really, really important for our customers. There's so many threats out today and so many attacks on customers that they really have to stay ahead. And not just for our commercial customers, but also our government customers are really, really interested in security. And so we're really excited that we're announcing actually two new services that are available for our GCC High customers. And that's Microsoft Cloud App Security and Azure Advanced Threat Protection.
And how does Microsoft Cloud App Security help customers?
Yeah, Microsoft Cloud App Security is all about securing access and information inside cloud apps. So government agencies still want to use cloud applications, but they want to secure it and protect it. So Microsoft Cloud App Security helps give visibility and control to who's accessing the cloud apps and what data is stored inside them.
And what about Azure ATP?
Yeah. Azure Advanced Threat Protection is all about protecting against identity threats. We know that 90% of breaches can actually be traced back to some kind of identity compromise. So protecting identities is really, really important, and that's what Azure ATP does for our customers.
And how do customers get started using these services?
Yeah, it's a great question. So these services are now available in the GCC High environment, so they can contact their partner or their Microsoft representative to get access to these solutions.
Oh, well, thank you very much, Adam, for your time.
And now for an update that I personally am very excited about. Microsoft Forms now supports a new question type that lets respondents add files to their survey responses. This will save owners from needing to follow up with respondents separately from the survey. All uploaded files will automatically be saved to a OneDrive for Business folder for easy access and tracking. To get started with this, when you're creating a question in a survey, click the three dots in the right-hand corner and select File Upload. And there you have it.
Sounds easy enough. If you haven't already heard, we've now combined Configuration Manager and Intune into a single product called Microsoft Endpoint Manager. In addition to that, the licensing for Endpoint Manager has been simplified to make Intune user licenses available to Configuration Manager customers that are co-managing Windows 10 devices. This simplified licensing removes barriers for Configuration Manager to connect to the cloud and lets customers get immediate value from Endpoint Manager. If you want to manage other workloads, including Android or even Apple devices, you'll just need to purchase additional Intune licenses. Microsoft Endpoint Manager with a new co-management licensing will be available in early December.
And here's an update new for insiders. There's now sticky notes integration in Outlook on the web. You can now easily view and create sticky notes directly in Outlook on the web, making it easier than ever to gather and keep all your ideas, thoughts, and notes in one place, which is kind of nice for me because I'm all over the place. but sticky notes integration will be rolling out next month. So let's throw it on over back to Arthur for a little more information about Microsoft Productivity Score.
With me right now is Senior Product Marketing Manager, AJ Smith, and AJ is going to talk about Microsoft Productivity Score. AJ, how are you?
Great, thanks for having me.
Yeah, so AJ, what is Microsoft Productivity Score?
So we've talked with a lot of organizations, and we found that over the past few years, the way people work is changing dramatically. They collaborate a lot more, they form a lot more teams, and of course, they want to work from anywhere and anytime. So we built Microsoft Productivity Score to help organizations understand how they could better work. We do this through providing insights that transform how people actually work.
And how does Productivity Score help organizations?
Well, we do this through focusing on three things. First is we want to give people visibility into how the organization actually works. And we do that by focusing on areas like how are people meeting, how are people communicating, how are people collaborating on content, and how people can work from anywhere. And then we also look at the technology side of this. So how does your technology enable people to be productive and get and do their best work? We also, of course, focus on the recommendations, because just because we give you that visibility, you probably want us to give you some idea of what you could be doing better. So we give you insights into how you can provide these improved experiences. And then last but not least, we want to give you the actions that you can take so you can update people's skills and systems so that everyone can do their best work.
And can you give us a concrete example on how Microsoft Productivity Score works?
Yeah, so in the collaborating with content section, one great way that we do is that we want to give you visibility into how people are actually collaborating. And one that we see that most organizations do is they share content over email. And there's really two ways to do that, through attachments and links. And attachments are a great way to collaborate, but the problem is that if I send out an attachment to a bunch of people, they're gonna send me that document back with all their comments and changes, and I've gotta mash all that together and figure out which ones I wanna take. But if I do links, we're all working from that one version of the truth, and it's a lot easier to collaborate. So we share that information with an organization and say, well, how many people are doing links versus attachments? And then we also give you the actions that you can take, like the training that you can send to people to say, hey, there might be a better way for you to actually share that information through links, and this is how you do it.
And what is your favorite feature?
My favorite feature is the benchmarking feature, because when we talk with a lot of organizations, they always want to understand how they compare with their peers. So what we did is we looked at other organizations like them based on factors like the size of their organization, the industry that they're in, and of course things like how long you've been in the Microsoft 365 or Office 365 service, because it'd be a little weird if we compared you with someone of like who's been in the service for 15 years versus two.
And how and where is this available?
So we've announced the private preview for Productivity Score, and it launches the first week of December. So if organizations want to learn more, they can go to aka.ms/productivityscoreblog to learn more about the solution and also sign up for the preview.
That's great. Well, thank you very much, AJ, for your time.
Thanks for having me.
And that's all we have for today. Thanks so much, everyone, for watching.
Yes, and be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. We love seeing your feedback. And I think we're going to head out and get some holiday prep going. So
oh, yeah.
We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye. So now that you've watched this video, don't forget to check out the Microsoft 365 blog that has a little more detail about what we went over today.